So there you have it. I think that was just about everything I wanted to talk about. God bless you, wonderful people. I love you, and I hope you are enjoying your life, and I hope you're happy, and I hope you feel loved, and I hope you have just the most success and prosperity and abundance that this wonderful world has to offer. God bless you. Bye-bye. I've been working on this Everyday Words of Wisdom series. I have 8 episodes so far. They're about 10 minutes each. And this is wisdom that I found about 15 years ago by Dr. Wayne Dyer. And this wisdom really impacted me at that time. I was on a, self-discovery journey. I was really on this big learning kick, and I was really into a lot of self-development or personal development kinds of gurus, and he was one of my favorites, absolutely. And about 10 years ago, I actually transcribed all of this wisdom from a video, and I really soaked it in. I mean, I listened to the video and I just typed it out, and it took quite a while. Quite a lot of wisdom. And anyways, over the last decade or so, I've returned to it every so often and toyed with it and rewrote a little bit of it. And now that I'm doing content creation, I made this series, and my hope is that at least somebody finds it useful. But I made it really for myself. Diving into this wisdom and really absorbing it, absorb it by when I make the videos, I have to write a script, and I have to review the script several times, and I have to practice reading it out loud a few times. I have to go back and edit it, little bits here and there, and then I really enjoy listening to them, actually. Some really powerful ideas that are, some of them, when I first heard them, seemed silly or impossible or very counterintuitive. But it really, really helped me. Helped me learn to accept the situation I was in then. And as I'm going over it now, it's helping me just this clarity of understanding and accepting that the world is the way it is, and my part in it. So anyways, I really enjoy that, because I've just falling into this trap of nihilism, which is really rough, actually. This just trap that nothing matters, and what's the point of anything? But here's my ultimate conclusion about nihilism, is nihilism destroys itself. Nihilism is the belief that all values are baseless and that nothing can be known or communicated. It is often associated with extreme pessimism and a radical skepticism that condemns the very existence that we live in. A true nihilist believes in nothing. They have no loyalties, and they have no purpose other than perhaps destruction. Learn more and more stuff, mainly from the James Webb Space Telescope, the JWTS, which they launched on Christmas 2020. I watched the launch of it. I followed the whole thing. It's a space telescope. It's similar to Hubble Space Telescope, although the Hubble Space Telescope is a optical telescope, which is kind of like a telescope or binoculars. Yeah, it's about 10 feet across. But the James Webb Space Telescope is a infrared telescope, and it's 27 times bigger than the Hubble. 27 feet across. It's enormous, and it can basically see to the beginning of time, or darn close to it. And anyways, I'm definitely going to be doing some more videos on that at some point. I did this. Anyways, in the last year, I've cranked out well over 2,000 videos over my 30 plus channels. And so I've learned a lot about video editing. And so I whipped together another version of it using my new improved video editing skills and software and whatnot. And I think it's hilarious. It's fun to learn how to edit. That's how I actually learned how to edit, with making stuff like that. And anyways, I have a million new funny ideas to do with it. So check that out. One other thing, my favorite guitar song, my original would be the Coon Fire, or Coon Didn't Start the Fire, 2023, which is a parody of Billy Joel's We Didn't Start the Fire. I have about 22 piano songs I'm working on. I've been studying piano for a long time, and now I finally get it, and now I can learn other stuff, and it just gets better and better. The more you learn, the more you can play, the more exciting it is. Of amazing piano songs that I'm playing right now, and that one is what has been a goal of mine to learn, and I'm finally starting to get it. Of course, I can play Fur Elise. Marty is on guard dog duty. He loves watching the traffic go by. Oh, he's so good at it. Look at that. Hey, buddy. Marty's very angry at this feather. Get it, buddy. Get the feather. Get it, buddy. Get the feather. Come on. Moving along, I wanted to talk a little bit about, I made this other video about, there was just two profound arguments against the existence of God. They are the divine hiddenness argument and the religious confusion argument. I'll just summarize them real quick. The divine hiddenness argument says that there shouldn't be any case of non-resistant non-believers in the world. What that means is, if God created humans and wants a relationship with them, then there shouldn't be any cases of people that would believe in God but don't just because they don't see any reason to, or they don't see enough evidence, or I know a lot of people like that. I mean, I guess you would call them agnostics, but so they're open to the idea, they just don't see any proof. So why is God remaining hidden from so many people? Of course, there's a lot of good explanations to that, like God must have good reasons, or perhaps there really are no cases of non-resistant non-believers in the world. But moving on, the next one is the religious Confucian argument, and this one also really baffles me. If there really was one God, then there shouldn't be so many different religions, because there are thousands of religions, of course, and there's a lot of good arguments for why that is. But this one says that God should make it really clear to us who he is, how to worship him. So there really should just be one religion. But if there is no God, then the thousands of religions make more sense, because they're not a result of some sort of divine intervention. They're the result of cultural or historical factors in different societies. Along those lines, I did a video a while ago about it's called The Mysterious Stranger. I do a reading from a book by Mark Twain called The Mysterious Stranger. And I read chapter 11. It's the final chapter in the book. And when I first read it, it just blew my mind. Because the whole book is about, I think it takes place in Austria in like the 1500s or something. So there's a small town and there's this group of boys, and they're approached one day by this mysterious stranger who introduces himself. He says his name is Satan. And he does clarify that he's not that bad Satan. That's his uncle. He's a totally different Satan. So anyways, he has all these, he takes the boys under his wing and does all this interesting, they go on all these journeys, but the final chapter is a conversation between Satan and young Theodore, where Satan says he's going away and he won't come back anymore. And Theodore says, but, you know, we'll meet in another life, surely. And Satan says, there is no other. There is no world. You are just a dream, a vision. And that nothing exists, because the world that we live in is so frankly and hysterically insane. A God that could have made good children as easily as bad, but yet preferred to make bad ones. Anyways, Satan provides a very provocative argument that, of course, there is no God, and there's no.
I, Princess Juna, old rock. Meo hera ite, go no hero ite kaewo, ma hon no juta nio.
Not perfect, but it's fun to do. You just do Someone Like You. This is such a good like breakup song to sing. It just feels good to sing. You know, never mind, I'll find someone like you. You don't fuck off. There you have it. I think that was just about everything I wanted to talk about. God bless you, wonderful people. I love you, and I hope you are enjoying your life, and I hope you're happy, and I hope you feel loved, and I hope you have just the most success and prosperity and abundance that this wonderful world has to offer. God bless you. Bye-bye.